Hello, YouTube. I just saw a video by the archfiend where he was commenting on a interview that Jericho did with a radio show about how he says that TNA is in a declining state. And how he figures how it went wrong, and what summed up that interview is Jericho says what they are doing has already been done, and they're trying to be the number two company in the declining state of professional wrestling. It's just really sad seeing the industry the way it is. I do agree with the Archfiend on a lot of his opinions. Like, the way pop culture is now, it just completely destroyed it enough to where nobody wants to watch anything. Like, Monday Night Football. No one wants to flip the channel over to Raw. They just want to keep it on the football game. Not even watch. WWE is at least trying to curb that. I've been interested in the Daniel Bryan storyline, but even that is starting to fall flat. It's alright, but some of it, that's not... Like, storylines like that during the Attitude Era, even before that, they could go months on end, but in this generation, everybody wants a storyline to be done and over with. Like, everybody cannot pay attention and invest time into a storyline for more than 2 months. Like, the Brian versus Corporation 2.0, this is a storyline that could stretch all the way to WrestleMania, but in the eyes of this, I don't see it lasting much longer after Survivor Series. Everybody wants the payoff right fucking now. And TNA is also suffering. Like, there's been very few top names that have come to WWE. And most of the top guys in the company all came from WWE. Like, interest in wrestling has not been like it was from, like, the Hogan era, New Generation, Attitude era, Ruthless Aggression era. It's like the state of wrestling is down all around. Like, WWE is suffering, but they're still above a 2 in the ratings. Independent wrestling suffering. Like, it's good to be nostalgic, but you gotta try to push through it, even through the bad times. That's what I want to add. Like, Chris Jericho pretty much nailed it on the head. He called it the old guys show. Like, I'll try to put the interview in the description if I find it. And this is the end of the video. Peace the fuck out.